How's the White House dealing with these problems?
Well, Wolf, really now they're sort of acknowledging the issues. You saw them putting more of a positive spin on it at first, saying that really this was a reflection of just how much demand there was on the website. There appears to be now, though, very much a recognition that there are structural problems with healthcare.gov. We heard President Obama really acknowledge that as well this week. He said there are more glitches than are acceptable. And that sort of comes, as we've heard from an independent analysis, that really only 1% of people who have registered, who have been able to register on healthcare.gov, or who have attempted to register, I should say, were actually able to enroll in Obamacare. Pretty dismal numbers.
So how are they going to fix this?
Well, really, it comes to fixing the website. That is number one. President Obama said there are employees working around the clock to get healthcare.gov up and running. And after that, having talked to some supporters of Obamacare today, Wolf, they say there's going to have to be another public education campaign. That President Obama, as we saw in the first week, he did a couple of high-profile events. There's going to have to be a reboot once the website is up and running. And also, I think there's also this question of a penalty that goes into effect at the end of March. There's this six-month enrollment process. That penalty kicks in at the end of that. Some are raising questions if perhaps that penalty time is going to be delayed because the real successful launch has been delayed.
Brianna, as you know, the House Energy and Commerce Committee is planning on holding hearings next week on the rollout of these health exchanges online. They've asked the Health and Human Services Secretary Kathleen Sebelius to testify. They wrote to her. As of right now, it doesn't look like she's going to accept their invitation.
No, that's right. An HHS official says she's unavailable. They say because of the government shutdown, they had a very short timeline to respond to this request. In a statement from a spokeswoman that says, "We are in close communication with the committee and have expressed our desire to be responsive to their request." But really behind the scenes, Wolf, the administration feels that this is not a real investigation, that it's a political dog and pony show. They look at Republicans who have really stood in the way of Obamacare, from Republican governors choosing not to launch state exchanges, which Democrats point out have been more successful than healthcare.gov, the federal exchange, even to the shutdown, which of course was Republicans who wanted to, it started with Republicans wanting to defund and delay Obamacare. So they don't really see this as a serious thing, Wolf, and they're kind of not eager to give political fodder to Republicans in the House.